Hey Lions, thanks for joining me for another lesson. I'm going to introduce you to a new sight word and then we'll practice the other sight words that we've already learned. The sight word I want to introduce you to is where. Where did my sock go? Where? I don't know about you, but whenever I do laundry, I always have a missing sock. Where? Let's spell it. W-H-E-R-E. Where? Good job. One trick I always remember for spelling the word where is remembering the word here is inside the word where. That can help you. So it begins like the wheezing whale, but then it also has the word here inside of it. So that can be a trick to helping you remember how to spell this word. Okay, let's read it and then we'll spell it and then we'll read it together. Here we go. Read. Where, spell W-H-E-R-E, where, good job. Okay, so the rest of these are sight words or heart words that we've already learned. Remember, we practice these because these are words used in stories over and over again, and a lot of them don't follow our rules, our spelling rules that we learned, so we need to know them automatically. Okay, my, spell M-Y, my. Remember, you need to read, spell, read right along with me so I should hear you. Go, G-O, go. Good job. I dropped one of these. Here's one of our contractions. Read it. Isn't, spell, I-S-N apostrophe T, isn't. And this is short for is not. Remember, a contraction is when you take two small words and you join them together with the apostrophe. Good. Read, under, spell, U-N-D-E-R. Read, under. Is, I-S, is. U, Y-O-U, U. Can't. C-A-N apostrophe T, can't. Get, G-E-T, get. R, A-R-E-R. She, S-H-E, she. We, W-E, we. Yes, Y-E-S, yes. And, A-N-D, and. No, N-O, no. On, O-N, on. The, T-H-E, the. Can, C-A-N, can. Good. Remember, read, spell, read with me. Read, I, spell, I, read, I. That one's easy. Read, me, spell, M-E, read, me. Read, spell, read. C-S-E-E-C. Two, T-O, two. Down, D-O-W-N, down. Was, W-A-S, was. Oops. He, H E he, saw, S A W, saw. All right, it's time for spelling. So if you can push pause if you do not have your pencil and paper handy. And for those of us that are ready, we'll get started. Okay, say sock. Sound it. Sock, sock. So I heard the ah sound. Remember, I'm making my tentacles like an octopus. So we're going to make sure we spell it with the ah sound. S-ock, sock. S-ock. And I hear the k sound at the end of the word. I know k at the end of the word can be spelled with C-K together. So that's what I tried, and it looked right. Now, if it didn't look right, then I would try it with just the C or with just the K at the end? Sock. Say dot. Like you dot the letter I, sound it, d-ot, dot. So go ahead and spell dot, d-ot, dot. Now, one thing I want you to look at carefully, d-ot, we heard the octopus sound. Make sure you put the stick on the correct side of the letter D. The D sound is the letter D, and it's easily confused with another letter. So I'm gonna show you how to do this. So when you make the letter D, the D sound, make a circle, and then you just put the stick on this side of the circle. And if you put it on the other side by accident, go ahead and erase it and fix it. It's one of those things where you want to get in the habit of doing it the right way. Otherwise, it can be more difficult for your brain to relearn it. So go ahead and make a change if you need to so that your D, the D sound, is facing the correct way. Okay? So when you make the D, it's circle first and then stick. Circle, stick, circle, stick. Okay, it's important for us to know. Okay, the next word we're going to spell is hot. My dinner is hot. Let's sound it. Hot, hot. Go ahead and spell hot. I hear the octopus sound again. Hot, like the tick-tock clock. Hot. So the H and the T, they go to the top line, hot. Okay, the next word we're going to spell is fall. Now, do you hear all inside of fall? Remember, we don't stretch out the sounds for all. We just say those sounds. I'm looking for my card. Here it is with all. So the word was all, fall. So we're just going to listen for the first sound, like the flying fish. And then we'll spell all, all, fall. Very good. So in this word, the F and the two L's go to the tip top line. Good job. All right, the last word we are going to spell is the word where, which is our new word, where. So two things can help you remember how to spell this word. It begins like the wheezing whale, and it has the word here inside of it, okay? So where, spell with me, W-H-E-R-E, where. As you write the word where, say the letters out loud so you see it, hear it, and you feel it while you're writing it. Where? W H E R E. Where? Good job, lions. So in this word, the H goes to the top line. The rest of the letters just go to the midline. All right. Good job with your spelling. Now let's read a new story. Remember, we read controlled stories, and all that means is they only have sounds and sight words that we have already learned. If it's underlined, that's one of our sight words or one of our heart words. So we just read that word automatically. The other words, we will stretch out the sounds, and then we're going to put it all back together again. That's what a good reader does. That way they can focus on what the story is about. Now, when I show you the page, I recommend that you pause it and you practice reading it on your own before we stretch it out together. That way you can go at your own pace. Okay, here we go. Where is my sock? Where is my sock? I feel that way every time I do laundry. There's always at least one missing. Oh, and look how this is set up, guys. You see there's a name, and then this is called a colon, the two dots. And what that means is that Sam, So that's his name, is saying this. So Sam is speaking. So it's almost set up. Let's look and see if every page is set up like this. It is. See, mom, and then the colon, Sam, colon. So this is set up almost like a play, and it's letting you know who's speaking. Okay. Sam, where is my sock? Mom, where did it go? Now we're going to go back and reread it, because remember, when we take time to sound it out, we might not be able to pay attention to what the story is about. And that's the whole point of reading, is to know what a story is about. So let's read that again. Sam, where is my sock? Mom, where did it go? So Sam is asking two questions. We know Sam's speaking because of the way the author structured the text. It has his name and then the colon. Mom, a sock can not run. Did you take it off? Mom, a sock cannot run. Did you take it off? I tell you what, if they have a dog like my Daisy, my beagle Daisy, it can run off in a beagle's mouth. Sam, I did take off my sock. It was hot in the sun. Sam, I did take off my sock. It was hot in the sun. So Sam is speaking there. Oh, now mom's speaking again. Mom, where did you take it off? Is it in the sack? Mom, where did you take it off? Is it in the sack? Sam, it is not in the sack. My sock is not on my hat. Sam. So Sam is speaking here. Sam, it is not in the sock sack. My sock is not on my hat. Sam, it is not on my rock. It is not under the mat. Sam, it is not on my rock. It is not under the mat. So now mom's speaking. Mom, did you ask Dad? Did Dad see it? Mom, did you ask Dad? Did Dad see it? And do you see, readers, how there are question marks at the end? So when you have a question mark, you raise your voice like you're asking a question. So I said, did Dad see it? Instead of just saying, did Dad see it? When you ask a question, they use the punctuation so you know how to change your voice to make it sound like you're actually speaking. Okay, let's see what happens. Sam, Dad has it. He's at on my sock. Sam, Dad has it. He sat on my sock. Oh, look at that. It was there all along. Has it ever happened to you when you're looking for something and then it was like right in front of your nose the whole time? That happens a lot in my house. All right, Lions, thanks for joining me for a lesson. I will see you right back here tomorrow. Have a great day.